Please be seated. The court is now in session. Mr. Deutschpare, could you report the attendance of the parties and individuals to today's proceeding?
Sur la présence des parties et autres personnes.
Deutschpare, Mr. President, for today's proceeding, all parties to this case are present.
Toutes les parties sont présentes.
On a side note, Nunchi is present in the holding cell downstairs.
Se trouve dans la cellule temporaire du sous-sol.
Pursuant to the trial chamber's decision concerning his health.
Par la chambre, compte tenu de son
thank
état
you.
De santé. Merci.
President, thank you.
Le président, merci.
We would like now to give the floor to the prosecution to continue presenting their key documents on JCE. You may proceed.
Ces documents clés sur l'entreprise criminelle commune. Je vous en prie.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honors. Morning, Council.
Le coprocureur. Merci, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour.
When we broke yesterday, I was presenting in the middle of a presentation showing the documents reveal the policy targeting officials and soldiers of the Law No Khmer public regime. And I was presenting from one category of documents that reflect this policy, which were S21 prisoner lists,
à savoir
particularly from the early period of the prison,
datant en particulier
that
des
show
débuts de la prison.
That one of the major group
on
of prisoners during that period were Law No soldiers and officials.
Parmi les principaux prisonniers, il
I
y avait
presented,
des responsables,
just presented one of those documents
des fonctionnaires
that showed
et des soldats
162
dans un de ces documents,
former Law No officials, soldiers, and relatives who were killed in 1 month alone, March of 1976. Let me note here that there are a number of other S21 records showing the targeting of this group. Document E3/2189 is a S21 list titled
Prisoners
Who Were Government Officials.
Intitulé Prisonniers qui sont d'anciens fonctionnaires.
This document is obviously relevant
ce document
in that the very title that was given by S21
pertinent,
to this list
puisque
reflects
S21 a
the targeting of government officials or civil servants.
Un nom qui montre que
and I would also note
ont été
that
l'objet de mesures
one of the documents that has been admitted by this chamber is E3/3597, E3/3597. This is a S21 prisoner list that identifies another 188 intellectuals, Law No soldiers, and government officials who were killed at S21 in 1976. Turning now to a
Présent,
document from the Standing Committee,
permanent,
which is document E3/197. This is the minutes of a Standing Committee meeting that was held on the 11th of March 1976 regarding the resignation of Sihanouk. This meeting was attended by Pol Pot, Nguyen Chea, Khieu Samphan, Son Sen, Foreign Vet, and Doyen. And at the start of section 2 of the minutes, and as yesterday my colleague will show the documents on the screen as the presentation proceeds, with your leave.
les documents à l'écran.
At the start of section 2 of these minutes, the following opinion of Ankar is expressed regarding the long-term reason for Sihanouk's resignation.
Quote,
fundamental class conflict between him and his family and the revolution. He cannot live with us. In the past, he could,
dans le passé,
only
il a
as a tactic.
Faire, mais uniquement comme
end
tactique.
Of quote. And later in the same document, when the meeting
document,
was reconvened on the 13th of March, 1976, the minutes reflect that the Standing Committee decided that they would let Sihanouk live, but would not allow him to leave the country. In regards to his children, however, the minutes record the following decision in paragraph 3 at Khmer 00000747, English 00182641, and French 00334963. The minutes read as follows, quote, send a wire for his children to come immediately, explaining that they are coming for the New Year's and the independence celebrations. We want to resolve this problem cleanly, end of quote. And a couple of paragraphs later, in paragraph 5, the Standing Committee explains its decision regarding Sihanouk as follows, quote, we must end feudalism just like this. The chess game has gotten to that point. The entire feudalist regime has been permanently smashed and dug out by the revolution. The kings existing over 2,000 years must, in the end, be clean. We have no way out other than this one. The next documents I will present, just a few documents from the military relating to this issue. A document E3/1162 is a report from the Secretary of Division 310, UN, dated the 26th of May, 1976. And this document is presented as it shows how biographies of division cadres were checked and how cadres identified as having relatives who were soldiers in the previous regime were reported to the center. Reading from paragraph 7, quote, this is paragraph 7 of the division secretary's report, quote, in Special Battalion 312, there remain three comrades who still hide their biographies, did not tell the truth about their own biographies. A. Heek. In his biography, he said he has not any political tendency, but when investigating his house, we found that his father was a soldier of an ambush unit in Kampon Tom. Number B in this list, Chan, indicates, quote, his brother served in the army for 1 year. And number C, the third person in paragraph 7, C, his father was a soldier who has now been missing.
À présent, il est porté disparu.
Document E3/813 is the minutes of a meeting that was held with Division 164 on the 9th of September 1976. That's document E3/813.
Document E3/813.
And I'll read just a short excerpt from section 3.2 of the minutes, which record the following report from Division 164 regarding the enemy situation in its region. Quote, mostly the civilians are good, but there are bad movements in the military. Recently, one soldier lieutenant of the former regime was discovered and arrested. End of quote. And in response, at the very end of the minutes, Son Sen instructed, quote, the soldier elements must be rounded up. End of quote. Next document is E3/807. That's
E3/807.
And this is the minutes of a meeting of the secretaries and deputy secretaries of the divisions held on the 1st of March 1977. And I will again just read a short excerpt from these minutes that appears at Khmer 00052305, English 00183949, and French 00323923. And in this part of the minutes, Division 920 Secretary Chin reports to the meeting as follows. Quote, after the studies, those who came to us from the Vietnamese and the children of soldiers, sub-district chiefs, and police were purged and sent to do production in one place. End of quote. The next group of documents relate to the targeting of Lon Nol soldiers and officials in the zones and autonomous sectors. And I will start with a number of documents from Tram Kok District, the district in the southwest zone. Document E3/2438 is a report titled List of Kampuchea Krom People from Kus Commune, dated 29th of April 1977. And there are the significance of this list, the reason we present it to you today, is that it is a list that identifies biographical information on people from this commune. One of the columns of information is titled rank. It is the second column from the end on the right side. And in that column, it is identified which people held positions in the Khmer Republic military. For example, the first person, it is recorded, the husband is a second lieutenant. Down on the next person, the husband is a first lieutenant, and so on. Your Honors, there are a number of such lists from other communes in Tram Kok District showing that this was a uniform practice, and I will cite to you two more of them. E3/2049 is the same type of list, only from Ang Tasom commune, dated the 30th of April 1977. And one more example, E3/2281 is a list from Trappiam Tom Chung commune,
de la commune de
Trappiam, dated the 4th of May 1977. In addition to these lists, there are a number of documents, reports from Tramcock District that reflect what happened when former Lawnol soldiers were identified. Document E3/2048 contains is a document that contains multiple documents from the district. There are three of them that I will present to you from E3/2048. First, at Khmer 00079089, English 00027656562-63, and French 00061-1659. At these pages, you will find a report from Ching Torn Commune Chief Moon, dated the 30th of April 1977, that reads as follows. Quote, request to make a report to beloved Tramcock District Ankar as follows. The enemy situation in our bases. After having received successive instructions from Ankar about being vigilant about the enemy and purging the enemy officers, we have tracked, examined, and found the following persons. The first person listed, individual name Chit Bil, a soldier, a second lieutenant, left Phnom Penh before 1970 to live in Ang Som. Second person on the list, named Q Soka. The report indicates we questioned him about his former position, and he responded that he had sold rice. But now we have tracked and examined the specifics. This one works in the Social Development Ministry. The report concludes then, quote, the above report is for Ankar's information. Along with this, we request to submit these people to the police and request that Ankar accept them. Also included in E3/2048, this document is at Khmer 00079090, English 00276563-64, and French 00061-1660. And at these year-end pages, you will find a report from Popol Commune dated the 2nd of May 1977. This report informs the district committee that 106 military families, totaling 393 persons, had been smashed by Ankar, that 231 military families remain, totaling 892 persons, and that, quote, there are some additional families for which it has not yet been determined if they are military or not, end of quote. And in the same series of reports at Khmer 00079091, English 00276564, French 00061-1661. You will find a document from the Tapem sub-district chief dated the 28th of April 1977, which reads as follows, quote, "We in the Tapem Subdistrict Cooperative Base branch have examined and purged the enemies who held ranks after having received the instructions of the party. Having closely examined this, we say there are still six more with officer and official ranks, and these people have personally carried out activities every single day. The names of the six are as follows. There is then a list of six soldiers with the ranks of first or second lieutenant. All of these are reported to Ankar. Whatever Ankar's decision, request, opinion, and instructions." End of quote. Document D-157.38, D-157.38 is another document from Tramcock, and the relevant ERN pages are Khmer 00143476, English 00032212133, and French 00061282838. And this is a titled a request for advice that comes from the Popel commune dated 11 April 1977. It is addressed to respected brother of the district party, and it states, quote, "For those people who held a ranking position, we will send them out to you consecutively. And for soldiers and some teachers who attempted to destroy our revolution, could you please give us advice what to do or let us decide at some bases?" And this request is signed, quote, "With high commitment to smash the spy of the enemy to its total extinction, in order to serve the socialist revolution and building socialism for our party and the people." End of quote. Your Honors, I've presented a number of the contemporaneous documents from Tramcock District. Let me now read a short excerpt from an interview of a former official from that district. I will not indicate his name. The document is D25/28. It was an interview conducted by OCIJ on the 30th of October 2007 of a person who was the district youth chairman in Tramcock district. And the relevant quote I will read is at Khmer 00 16 34 93, English 00 22 34 76, and French 00 65 12 59. Question. Where did those prisoners come from?
D'où venaient ces prisonniers?
Why were they detained there?
Pourquoi ont-ils été placés
referring
en détention là-bas?
To Prang Tachan prison in Tramcock district.
À la prison de Tram
Answer,
à Tramcock.
Probably the majority were the brothers and sisters who had been evacuated from the cities, those called the 17 April
C'était
group.
Ceux qu'on appelait les 17
it was mixed. There were some former soldiers
C'était un groupe
and
mélangé.
Base people.
Il y avait d'anciens soldats et des gens du peuple de base.
Question. Who ordered the imprisonment of the 17 April people? Who sent them there? Answer. From what I know, in general, the killings had begun ever since 17 April. It was the army who were the earliest killers before entering Phnom Penh. Question. Were the 17 April group arrested by the militia and sent to Krang Ta Chan? Answer. I don't know what level decided the plan. When they arrived there, they had them make biographies, and anyone whose biography said they had been a soldier would disappear. End of quote. Your Honors, I would now like to read to you from the June 1977 Revolutionary Flag. This is document E3/135. And the first section of this issue of Revolutionary Flag
dans la première partie,
is an announcement that the party's central committee has, quote, decided that any district with the best qualifications in terms of defending the country, continuing socialist revolution, and building socialism must receive the honorary red flag. Continuing two paragraphs later, during this past year of 1976, the party made an assessment and saw three districts with model qualifications in terms of defending the country, making socialist revolution, and building socialism. These three districts are 1. Passat district in the east zone, number 2. Kampong Tralak Lu district in the west zone, also known as district number 12, and 3. Tram Kok district in the southwest zone. These three districts were awarded the honorary red flag by the Central Committee. And at Khmer 00062795, English 00446865050, and French 00487712. The revolutionary flag indicates that these districts are being held out as a model for the rest of the country, for, among other things, at paragraph 3, quote, waging strong and profound class struggle within the entire district, especially inside the party, end of quote. Now, I have already presented documents and a witness statement to you from one of the districts that was recognized as a model district by the Central Committee. At this time, let me read a couple of statements from witnesses from one of the other districts that was recognized as a model district by the Central Committee, that is Kampong Tralak Lu district from the West Zone.
District de Kampong Tralak dans la zone ouest.
Let me read first from document D-232/44. D-232/44. This is an OCIJ interview that was conducted on the 29th of October 2009. Of the deputy chair of the commune militia in Krang Leve commune in Kampong Tralak district. And I will read Just one short excerpt. This is question and answer number four from this interview. Question. Were the people evacuated from Phnom Penh taken for execution? Please describe the event at that time. Answer. As far as I know, those evacuated people were taken for execution. At that time, those people were taken to Chumti Krang village in Krang Leve commune. The meetings were held many times, every time when the people arrived. Sometimes the meetings were held at the cooperative. The people who chaired the meetings were Tayem, Tavong, and Tasarun. During the meetings, they advised the new people to try hard to work in the cooperative. And a person wrote down, when they asked the name, what they did in Phnom Penh and if they were soldiers. Later on, those who were Lon Nol soldiers disappeared from the cooperative, while some of those who were not soldiers survived. End of quote. Next is document D-125-91, and this is an interview that was conducted by OCIJ on the 4th of August, 2008. The individual interviewed was a person who, at the start of the regime, was a District 12 soldier and later a guard at the district prison, Damri Swat. I will read a couple of excerpts from this interview. First, at Khmer 0021-2109. English 00275111 and French 00342628. Question. Can you clarify word prisoner, which you just used? What did that mean? Answer. A prisoner was a person accused of being the enemy, like the 17 April people, for instance, who were people who had just been evacuated from Phnom Penh into District 12, and the base people. Anyone who had done something wrong, like moral offenses related to sexuality, transplanting the wrong species of rice, stealing potatoes, and those accused of having been Lon Nol soldiers were also CIA enemies. We're all accused of being the enemy. And a couple of questions later. Question. How many times did you hear them interrogated? Answer. I heard them interrogate many times. For example, were you a Lon Nol soldier or not? Are you a CIA connection or not? If the prisoner answered no, M would beat the prisoner. And then continuing two questions later. Question. What were the causes of death of the persons whose bodies were buried in the pits? People died from diseases, from lack of medicine, from lack of food. In 1975, I saw them walking hundreds of people to be killed at Phnom Krek in Krang Leve subdistrict without any interrogations. They were 17 April people and Lon Nol soldiers. I did not know where they had been brought from. I participated along with a 30-man unit of District 12 soldiers led by Sun in walking those people to be killed at Phnom Krek.
À être tué à Phnom Penh.
Your Honors, I will stop reading from witness statements. There are many witness statements I could read from. Those have been identified in our filing of relevant witness statements to this policy. I will move on to a couple more documents and then wrap up my presentation on law and old targeting. The next document I will present is E3/193. This is a August 1977 issue of Revolutionary Flag that published a presentation by a party organization representative at the 25 July 1977 West Zone Cadre Conference. It is indicated at the start of the presentation, the very start, quote, "I wish to make a presentation regarding the instructions of the party on a number of important matters for implementation in the second semester of 1977. And the specific part that I would like to direct Your Honors to appears at Khmer 00062960, English 00393992 32, and French 00611836. And at this specific part of the speech, the party representative complained that many cooperatives in the West Zone were controlled by former Khmer Republic soldiers, stating as follows, quote, "In District 18, there were not just a few. From what I know, some cooperatives have former regime soldiers, not just soldiers as members, but soldiers in the leadership post-liberation elements. More than a few of them are responsible for leadership with the cooperatives. Kampon Leng also has more than a few. Ponealu is not much different. In Sector 37, they are even more plentiful. And in the subsequent parts of this presentation, the zone cadres were directed to, quote, attack and smash the enemy and the no good elements embedded inside and controlling the cooperatives, and at the end of the document to ensure that, quote, by late 1977, at least 50% or more of the cooperatives throughout the entire zone be set up to be good and clean in accordance with the class line, end of quote. Next document showing the targeting of law and order officials or soldiers in the zones is a telegram from the Central Zone Secretary dated the 2nd of April 1976, which is document E3/952. And this is a telegram from the Central Zone Secretary, Kai Pak, addressed to Brother Paul, copied to Nguyen Chea and Son Sen. Section 1 of this report is titled The Enemy Situation in the Entire North Zone, and I will read from that first section a couple of quotes. Quote, "In general, the situation is stable, but at the same time, they have carried out some activities. For example, they make propaganda that the revolution is strict. They made propaganda to resist the cooperatives and the new rice field dike system. And they made propaganda about hunger. Specifically, some activity has appeared in Chamkarlu district. The enemies are former soldiers in combination with the Cham and former cooperative team chairman." And continuing in the next paragraph, quote, Regarding the above enemy activity, the zone has taken measures and instructed the sectors to concentrate on tracking down these activities. In so tracking that activity, we captured some elements who were former cooperative team chairmen. Along with this, they have agents embedded inside. We tracked and examined that to learn their composition, and we will take additional measures. End of quote.
Pour voir jusqu'où cela va aller, et nous allons prendre des mesures supplémentaires.
Your Honors, E3/179 is a report from the Northwest Zone,
de la zone West.
Office M560, addressed to Ankara, dated the 29th of May, 1977.
Envoyé à l'Ankara en date du 29 mai 1977.
And the relevant part appears at Khmer 00008498, English 00183011-12, and French 00236768-69. And at these pages, the Northwest Zone Office reports on the arrest of 42 people in Sector 3,
de l'arrestation de 42
noting
personnes dans
as follows,
3,
quote,
et souligne,
"We have observed these acts actually arose from among old veteran soldiers and those with the ranks of second lieutenant, first lieutenant, captain, and major who hide themselves in collectives and who we have never found before. Recently, their acts have shown up clearly. We have already taken steps and arrested all of them." End of quote. The last two documents I will present on this policy, Your Honors, are two documents from the North Zone. E3/1144 is a telegram from the North Zone Secretary, say, to Committee 870, dated the 5th of September, 1977. This telegram was copied to Uncle, Uncle Nguyen, Brother Van, Brother Vaughan, and Brother Q. And at the end of Section 1 of this telegram, at the bottom of Khmer 00069447, English 00517923, and French 00532726. On these pages, at the bottom of that page, you will find a report titled Situation of the Internal Enemy, in which the Zone Secretary reports as follows, quote, "At the bases, offices, ministries, and military offices, we have uncovered many enemies who are burrowing from within, either through the spying of their anti-revolution activities or through the implications. Those enemies who were former officials, policemen, or soldiers of the previous regime were discovered one after another." End of quote. And my last document is E3/996. It is a 19 March 1978 telegram, also from the North Zone Secretary to Committee 870. In the last paragraph of this telegram is a report on the situation of the enemy burrowing from within, which reads as follows, quote, "In this dry season, the remaining enemies re-emerged and took actions against us in the work sites. These enemies contacted with the former policemen, soldiers, and government officials. They mingled themselves as the new people. After they acted against us, we knew them clearly, and we systematically purged them." End of quote. Your Honors, that ends my presentation relating to the policy targeting Wagner soldiers and officials. At this time, I will, my national colleague here, will do a short presentation on forced marriage.
Va maintenant faire une présentation sur les mariages forcés.
The President. Thank you, Council. You may now proceed.
Vous avez la parole.
Mr. Chandararyasamy. Thank you, Mr. President, and thank you, Your Honours, and very good morning to the bench, and very good morning to everyone in and around the courtroom. On behalf of the prosecution, I now would like to present the relevant documents concerning regulation of marriage during the Democratic Cambodia.
Sous le régime du Cambodia.
Regarding the DK policy towards marriage, or more precisely, forced marriage,
pour
it is necessary
first to
present documents that concern the ultimate objectives of the regime in terms of population growth, then documents in relation to the concept of revolutionary family. Mr. President and Your
Honours,
before I proceed to these key documents, I would like simultaneously ask the President to also allow the documents to be displayed on the screen when I will be reading the ERN numbers of the document. First, allow me to present document number 1, which is document E3/25, or the 243/2.1.9. Revolutionary flag, December 1976, January 1977. Article entitled The Presentation of the Comrade Party Representative on the occasion of the 9th anniversary of the brave, strong, skilled, and magnificent Revolutionary Army of Cambodia,
speech
by Nguyen Chia.
Discours prononcé par Nguyen Chia.
Under the title, which is
sous le titre.
Key point to this is point number 4 regarding the mission of continuing to strengthen and expand the Revolutionary Army of our party. This document can be found under Khmer ERN 0006-3054. English ERN 00491435 and French 00504063. Nguyen Chia says, so then the essence of the socialist revolution and building socialism is the goal of building the country well, defending the country well, and sorting out the livelihood of the people quickly. We need from 15 to 20 million people to meet the needs of our land. For our population to constantly increase, the livelihood of the people must rise, and they must be in good health. So then this means quickly increase production. Another document is document E3/15/86 or IS 20.10, United Nations General Assembly 32nd Session,
discours prononcé
28th Plenary Meeting
par
the 11th of October 1977, speech by Yeng Sari. This document is particularly relevant as it highlights the fact that the regime has a need of more manpower for the size of the country's territory.
la taille du territoire.
Improving the living conditions of people is not a necessity to improve the well-being of individual persons.
Améliorer les conditions de vie de la population n'est pas nécessaire pour améliorer le bien-être.
This document is not available in Khmer, but it is available in English and French, and ERN in English can be found under ERN 007-9813.
Page
00013 et en français 00761. Mr. Yang-Seri said, and I would like to cite paragraph
45 as follows. Dit,
and this ERN number in Khmer can be found under 00291028 and English 00079815 and French ERN is 00061 77 98 99. And I would like to cite also this paragraph as follows. We are endeavoring very rapidly to improve the living conditions and the health of our people. Because we need a population of 15 to 20 million in 10 years' time.
Besoin d'une population de 15 à 20 millions d'ici 10 ans.
And I would like to now cite paragraph 63.
But
with regard to the long-term aspirations of our people, the road that we have yet to travel is long indeed. We must redouble our efforts. We are endeavoring as rapidly as possible to improve still further the living conditions of our people so that everyone may have sufficient strength and health
and
attend patriotism so that our entire people may rapidly and constantly progress and that we may continue in the defense and speedy construction of
a prosperous Cambodia.
We have no reason to reduce the size of our population or to maintain it at its present level, for with close to 8 million inhabitants, our population is still far short of our country's capacity, which has a need of more than 20 million people. This is why our objective is to bring about a very rapid increase in our population. In another letter to the United Nations, 6 months later in April 1978, Yang-Seri speaks of successful results in terms of increment of the population, which is ascribed as a policy of the regime. Your Honours, the Democrat Cambodia regime tentatively provided some statistics regarding an alleged population growth. And I would like now to present document E3/686 or D56 document 234. BBC SWB report entitled Interview with DK Leader on Population Policy and Struggle Against Vietnam,
27 October 1981,
excerpts from a recorded interview with Nguyen Chia, chairman of the Cambodian People's Representative Assembly and head of the DK delegation to the Asian
et chef de la délégation du
Parlementarians Conference in Peking on Population and Development.
À la conférence des parlementaires
this document
de l'Asie à Beijing
is available
sur
in Khmer
la population
under ERN
le développement.
Ce document
est disponible en Khmer
English
à la page 00
6443-0349, French 0059-9792.
En anglais 0003.
Under these year numbers, Mr. Nguyen Chia Say,
we are faced, nous sommes confrontés,
with the problem of being sparsely populated.
Nous sommes confrontés au problème
that d'avoir the size of our population was not proportionate to Cambodia's area. Its natural resources, which might be exploited for national construction,
or its needs
regarding territorial defense. Since 1975, democratic Cambodia has always required a rapid increase in its population.
Thus,
the four-year plan of 1977 to 1980 aimed at increasing our population to at least 15 million within 5 to 10 years. As a result of this plan, our population has increased as follows. From March to December 1976, it increased by 160,000 people, or 2%. In 1977, it increased by 220,000 people, or 2.8%. And in 1978, it increased by 260,000 or 3.2%. This increase was the result of the policy of Democratic Cambodia to protect the people's lives primarily by solving and improving the people's living conditions.
Concept of family under the DK period.
Le concept de la famille sous la période du Cambodge démocratique.
In a series of DK documents, the regime explains how the traditional concept of family was now superseded by the revolutionary family and how thinking about family own interest was equivalent to a betrayal. And I'd like to refer to document E3/10 or D243/2.1.7. It is a revolutionary youth special issue, September through October 1976. The article entitled Honing the Ideology of the Proletarian Class to its sharpest and mightiest. In Khmer, the year and is 006-3104, and in English 0045-0538, and in French 0049-1904-05. Under the title number 4, on the class struggle between the private ownership of the various classes opposed through the collective ownership of the proletarian class. This document raises the issue of private property. Other manifestations, private ownership in organization, organizing by one's personal sentiments, by one's family, by one's clique, and not standing upon the political, ideological, and organizational line of the party, so then that is wrong.
Et le rejet de la ligne ideologique
also in this document, under point number 2,
cela est négatif.
which states the bad characteristics and dangers of private ownership. It also reads, no aspect of private ownership is good. Privée.
Aucun aspect de la propriété privée n'est bon.
During the struggle or the armed struggle or during the war,
pendant private armée,
ownership always has a negative impact on the revolution. For example, anyone who thinks a lot about family interest always deceives the revolution,
qui pense beaucoup à leurs intérêts familiaux,
renounces the revolution and lives separately.
Ces gens abandonnent la révolution,
seeking family happiness and not seeking happiness inside the party.
Familial et non le bonheur.
After a while, this becomes a contradiction with the party.
Cela devient une contradiction.
The enemy entices some elements with moderate private ownership, not to work hard, just to stay quiet and be happy. But some elements who worked hard have also betrayed the revolution.
L'ennemi les encourage à ne pas travailler.
Journals.
Et à
the following document is of particular relevance, as it says that not only the sacrifice of family, parents, relatives, and children is encouraged in order to serve the party,
mais des éléments
but family members are considered as private material possessions.
Que le parti encourage
and I'd like to refer to document
E3/750
or the
243/2.1.21.
It is a revolutionary youth.
Je passe au document E3/750 ou 243/2.1.21. C'est un numéro de l'étang de la revue
the
Jeunesse
second article entitled
novembre 75.
To eliminate the individual and private possession decisively and strengthen and expand the collective possession forcefully,
individual et privé, et renforcer la propriété collective.
The Khmer EAN is 006-3614-215 and the English EAN is 0052-2460 and in French 0052-5856-257. On these EANs and the heading 2, there is the status of possession in our revolution rank.
Le statut de la propriété dans les rangs révolutionnaires.
In our revolution rank, our revolutionary male-female combatants and cadres sacrifice the private possessions such as housing,
paddy farm,
garden,
leurs biens privés, comme leur maison,
family, parents, leur jardin, relatives, children,
leur ferme, leur famille,
and other properties
enfants,
in order to serve the party,
autres, pour se mettre au service
revolution
du parti,
and
de la
the people.
Et du peuple.
After joining the revolution rank and receiving constant propaganda, education, and instruction from the party, our comrades have strived to build the higher stance of sacrificing of material, ideology and sentiment.
Ces forces de renforcer leur position consistant à sacrifier tout ce qui est matériel
and
ainsi que
sentiment
leur idéologie et leurs sentiments.
Only care about, sympathize with and
ensuite,
love their own family, friends, relatives and parents.
Que la possession sentimentale était le fait de ceux qui
for the people, these are the wrong activities
famille,
stemming from the individual possession stance.
Et leurs propres parents. Il est indiqué
which is the ideology of the oppressive classes,
d'une
including the imperialist,
d'appartenance
feudalist, and capitalist.
À l'idéologie
our revolutionary male-female youth must see this and have a clear view that the individual possession ideology still exists in our revolution rank, our revolutionary male-female youth rank, and ourselves. We see this situation objectively in order to be vigilant and to resist it constantly
and have a practical measure to deal with it. Vigilant et résister en permanence et prendre des mesures pratiques.
And to absolutely eliminate it.
Absolument ces tendances.
Next, I would like to refer to another document that is E3/766 or D248/4.11. This is another revolutionary youth, issue 11, November 1978, the article entitled Revolutionary Short Story, The Child of the Party. In this propaganda story for the youth, a 15-year-old boy is interviewed and given as an example for his determination to smash all June.
Dans cette histoire,
this is what this child of the party says about his family and his parents.
Et on le donne en modèle pour sa détermination à écraser.
You can find this document and text in Khmer EN 00376532 and in English 0052-4181 and in French 0059-3981. Quote,
voici ce que dit cet enfant concernant
I have no parents or siblings.
Sa famille et ses parents. Je cite. Je n'ai ni parents,
I am the child
ni
of the Communist Party of Cambodia.
Fils du Parti communiste du Cambodge.
My parents and my siblings were killed and smashed by the June enemy
et éliminés par les
during
June
their invasion in 1976. The villagers, my house, my rice paddies were destroyed and plundered.
Détruit et pillé
by the June enemy and taken
Yun,
back to their country.
Ont emporté le fruit de leur
now
piège
I am living in a new family.
À présent, je vis au
my
sein d'une
boy
nouvelle
troops sport.
À savoir,
and
mon
my parents are none other than the Communist Party of Cambodia.
Ne sont autres
and
que
I
le
will
Parti
now strive my best. End of quote.
Fin de citation.
Journals, the next documents that I refer to.
Je passe au document suivant.
Is the most important contemporaneous document
c'est
as for the concept of family and regulation of marriage.
Pour ce qui est de la
although published
de
as early as
mariage.
February 1974, it was republished under the DK era, which shows that its content was still relevant and reflecting the CPK policy at the time.
Et qu'il correspondait à la politique du PCK à l'époque.
I will first read excerpts relevant to the family in general, then those relevant to the regulation of a marriage.
Puis un extrait portant sur la réglementation du
document E3/775 or D267/3.36. It is a CPK publication entitled Revolutionary and Non-Revolutionary Worldviews regarding the matter of family building.
Et non révolutionnaire sur la création de la famille.
It is an accurate reprint of the Jute issue dated 2nd February 1974 by the East Zone Political Military Ministry on 2nd June 1975.
Le 2 juin 1975.
And the publication on the 2nd September 1975 was for 1,000 copies. The Khmer-EN can be found at 0040-7098 and in English 0041-7942, in French 00. In the old society before liberation and inside zones temporarily controlled by the enemy today,
avant la libération et dans les zones qui étaient provisoirement contrôlées par l'ennemi,
President, you may proceed, prosecutor.
Nous sommes allow
me to continue, Mr. President. In the old society before liberation and inside zones temporarily controlled by the enemy today, many youths have absorbed the world views of the oppressor class.
La vision du monde de la classe des oppresseurs.
They search out spouses or build families only out of personal material greed.
Par intérêt matériel personnel.
That is to say, they seek out family interest or happiness by completely breaking from the interest and the fate of the entire nation and people,
de la destinée de l'ensemble de la nation et du peuple.
And now I move on to another EAN page in Khmer, which is 0040-7100, and in English 0041-7942, and in French 0059-3929. On that page and under heading true,
voici ce qui apparaît sous le titre
regarding the revolutionary world views toward the matter of family building, I'd like to state the following quote.
La
As for us, the revolutionary Jews, we consider matters of family as being inseparable from matters of the entire nation and people.
De l'ensemble de la nation et du peuple.
When our nation is unmercifully oppressed,
opprimée,
exploited, and placed under hardship by the imperialist, feudalist, capitalist,
mise en difficulté à cause
our families are also exploited.
Nos familles sont également exploitées.
Therefore, in order that our families may know true happiness, peace,
le vrai bonheur,
and prosperity, our entire nation and people must first be liberated and freed from every type of
exploitation
by the reactionary imperialist,
de la part
feudalist,
des
capitalist.
Des féodaux et des
so,
capitalistes réactionnaires.
Building our revolutionary families is not just for our personal interest or happiness,
seulement lié à nos intérêts ou à notre bonheur personnel,
or to have children and grandchildren to continue the family line.
Importantly,
It is so that the revolution may achieve its highest mission, to liberate the nation, the people, and the poor class, and then advance towards socialism and communism,
à la construction du socialisme et du communisme,
which are societies in which people no longer exploit other people.
End dans laquelle of quote. L'exploitation n'existe plus.
And again, further down on the Khmer year and 00407102, and in English 0041 79 44, and in French 00 59 39 31. Under heading 2, that is the bad outcomes of improperly building families,
les conséquences négatives,
I like to make the following quote.
De famille mal construite.
The strategic enemies and the tactical enemies,
les ennemis stratégiques
and the class enemies,
et les
who are still living in liberated zones,
qui continuent de vivre dans les zones
due
libérées,
the maneuver of wanting to hit us in the guts,
manœuvre,
by inserting their people to bore holes from within, to wreck our ranks from within,
leurs,
by attracting their relatives, by attracting them by family emotions and inciting them to break away from the revolution, to oppose the revolution, or to betray the interest of the revolution and the people, and serve family interests, protect their class, etc. End of quote.
En défendant leur propre classe et en servant leurs intérêts familiaux.
Further down, for the second paragraph under the same heading, I'd like to quote the following. Therefore, our revolutionary youth comrades must pay attention and be really vigilant toward this matter of family building.
La constitution des familles.
If we do not respect organizational discipline, if we do not respect the collective, if we do not take firm revolutionary stances, and if we are free and all over the place in terms of morality, we will surely build families incorrectly and not be accordance with the party line. And we will surely encounter bad elements or even clandestine enemy agents.
End
of quote. Your Honours, further down on the Khmer year and 00407103, and in English 00417945, and in French 0059 3932. I'd like to read the following quote. Many bad things are caused by liberal family building, disrespecting organizational discipline, not adhering to revolutionary stances. They all endanger the party, the revolutionary movement, and all of us.
Tout cela met le parti, le mouvement
révolutionnaire. If we hit upon bad elements when we build families,
si nous rencontrons de mauvais éléments,
at the very least, they will induce us to be inactive in our revolutionary missions.
Nous inciter à
others
être inactifs
may
dans
ask that we leave the party and leave the revolutionary movement.
End of quote. Et le mouvement révolutionnaire.
Now I'd like to move on to another topic that is forced marriage.
Celui des mariages forcés.
And I will refer to the same documents that is E3/775 or D267/3.36. This document contains passages explaining that the organization and collective decisions regarding the choice of the spouse must be absolutely respected, as they know better who should marry who.
La décision de l'encadre
and
la décision de la collectivité.
I'd like to refer to KMAI EN 0040 7100 201. In English,
je donne les URN.
0041 7943 and in French 0059 3930. Under heading 1, how should we, the revolutionary youth, choose a spouse? I'd like to make the following quote.
Nous, les jeunes révolutionnaires.
In order to achieve the missions of the revolution successfully,
les missions de la révolution,
we,
nous,
the revolutionary youth,
les jeunes révolutionnaires,
must be really vigilant.
Nous devons faire preuve
in selecting our spouses.
Dans le choix.
One. It is imperative to be vigilant in regard to sexual morals.
D'être vigilant en matière de morale sexuelle.
Do not choose recklessly all over the place.
Il ne faut pas se répandre de manière
indiscriminée. When marrying, it is imperative to honestly make proposals to the organization,
quand on se marie,
to the collective, to have them help sort things out.
À l'encart et à la collectivité.
Two. Organizational discipline must be absolutely respected in the matter of building a family, no matter the outcome of the organizational and the collective assessments and decisions. They must be absolutely respected. Do not have hard feelings. Do not be disappointed. This is because only the organization and the collective are able to make a thorough assessment from every aspect.
Ceci parce que l'encadre
Three.
Et le collectif sont en
Do
mesure
not go helter-skelter in
la
a rush.
Situation.
Do not be hard to follow whatever your heart sees. It is imperative to look at their background very clearly first. That is to say, they must be clean in living morals and clean politically without involvements with any enemy strings
sur le plan
or
moral et
bad elements.
La personne envisagée ne doit avoir aucun lien avec l'ennemi ou de mauvais éléments.
If both are inside the ranks,
quatrièmement, si les deux personnes
it is imperative
font partie des rangs,
to choose someone
il est
who has a solid
a
revolutionary stance,
une position révolutionnaire solide.
No matter what their position may be,
quelles que soient ses fonctions,
they must have a stance of absolute combat.
Il est indispensable
to constantly fulfill revolutionary missions
en
for
vue
the party, the revolution, and the people.
En permanence, les missions révolutionnaires.
Therefore, we do not just choose
parti,
someone who is good looking.
Par conséquent, il ne faut pas
and who knows how to dress
qui
and make themselves up playfully
et s'habiller
in the modern imperialist style,
qui adopte
or
les
who is the child of a wealthy person, or who has high old society cultural abilities,
l'enfant d'un riche,
or who is capable of oratory, or who is a pistol or rifle-toting comrade,
du point de vue de
or
la culture de l'ancienne société.
Some high
il ne faut pas choisir quelqu'un parce que c'est
quote.
Un bon orateur ou parce que c'est quelqu'un qui sait
another section of the same document deals with the relationship with the spouse after marriage.
Il y a une autre partie and qui for porte that aussi I like to refer to Khmer Ia and le Ren 00 et le suivant
40 7104 205 English 0041 0049 7945 2 46 46 and in French 0059 0059 3932 and the heading 2 in the same document on the view of bidding and educating the spouse after marriage. I'd like to make the following quote.
L'édification we must et have the clear view
that our spouse is one inseparable part of the great revolutionary family.
Therefore, de la
our husband or wife
notre mari
is one of the party's masses
fait donc partie
and
des
is a member of the revolutionary movement. In order to have our spouse become a good revolutionary spouse,
being
able to fulfill
revolutionary
missions well for the party, the revolution and the people forever, it is necessary to gradually educate and build them to understand the revolutionary political, ideological and organizational lines.
Et l'amener à
do not leave them alone,
la ligne politique,
leave them just to cook
or
to look after the children and to look after the house like families in the
notre
old society did.
Ne doit pas
for one thing,
simplement
we,
faire la
the
cuisine,
husband, must concentrate
enfants,
on making propaganda and educating and building them to follow the path of the party line. But most importantly, we must hand them over for the organization and the collective
à la ligne du parti.
To help educate
plus important
and build.
Encore, il faut confier la conjointe à l'encart et à la collectivité en vue de la former et de l'éduquer.
It is absolutely imperative to avoid spoiling the spouse.
Il est absolument impératif.
Do not consider your spouse to be some special member of the masses that only you can build, that only you can
est un membre spécial
educate
des masses que toi seul peux former et édifier.
And it is absolutely imperative that you do not build your spouse to follow their own individual family emotions.
D'encourager ton épouse à suivre
and through the experience that we have received only by handing over the family for the organization, for the collective,
confiée à l'encart et à la
to help educate and build,
seulement de cette manière,
and by having them go down into the fray inside the mass movement, can our families prosper well in the direction of the party.
Au sein des masses, pour que la famille puisse ainsi prospérer.
Mr. President, and your honors, I would like to present three remaining documents to conclude my
presentation.
Thank you, Mr. President. The following document is document E3/681. D56-DOC.209, the statement of Ying Sari in New York Times Sin, an article entitled Pol Pot 8, calls for world support by Henry Kim, 1st of December 1980. In this interview, Mr. Ieng-Seri explains that from 1980 onwards, some freedoms will be given to people under the DK control, including the right to marry freely or the right for the families to live together unlike before.
Sous le contrôle du comité démocratique, comme le roi de se marier librement, et le droit des familles à vivre
I would like to cite the EON number of this document in Khmer 00651246, English 00122194, and French 00630693-94. I would like to cite this document as follows, quote, the Prime Minister, rather, the Deputy Prime Minister spelled out details of the new program espoused by his colleagues, Mr. Ieng-Seri said, that all political parties would now be allowed. And he continued, we will allow freedom for all religions and education. Marriages will be free and families live together. Economically, the Deputy Prime Minister said, we will introduce the protection of private property for our citizens and foreigners who want to invest in Cambodia. He added, there will be voluntary, not enforced, cooperatives, not like before, and cooperation with foreign companies. After all, we are an undeveloped country. Mr. President, let me also conclude this presentation with the words of the excerpt from Mr. Philip Short. This book by Mr. Philip Short is not available in Khmer, and they are only available in French and English. I would like to read the entire French text, and I would like to refer to this page as follows. Document E3/9. English ERN 00396533-34. French ERN 00639883. I will be reading in French as follows.
La famille continue à exister.
The family continued to exist.
Mais son objectif premier fut désormais d'engendrer des enfants au service des partis. Les liens entre les différents membres d'une famille
furent
diluées dans la communauté.
Ties between individual
les mères ne devraient pas être trop encombrées par leur progéniture.
Mothers should not get too entangled with their offspring.
Déclara Paul au comité central.
Told the central
de même si on nomme santé qu'il commençait à s'attacher sentimentalement à une femme.
A sentimental attachment.
Il devrait assumer une position collectiviste et résoudre ce problème.
Take a collectivist stance
and resolve it.
To do otherwise is to have a very strong private stance.
Marriage
not merely between party members, but between any two people,
was
a party and not an individual affair. Free choice of spouse
pour en souligner l'aspect social,
was explicitly condemned to underline the social aspect. Weddings were celebrated collectively for a minimum of 10 couples. After a marriage had been consummated, the couple often lived apart, subject to the death penalty.
Mr. President and Your Honours, that concludes our presentation, and we are very grateful indeed. The President, thank you very much. It is now an appropriate moment already for the adjournment. The Chamber will adjourn until 11 a.m.
Somme Jane Grouchard.